Hello and welcome to this At One With Animals Conversations to Inspire. These conversations are in support of the White Lion Trust, and I will give you their website address in the description of this video. And today my guest is Andrea Contri, who lives in Italy, and he trained in 2010, he trained with Winter Wursthorn, and his life has just and his experiences have just exploded out from that workshop. So welcome, Andrea. Thank you so much for agreeing to be my guest today.
Thank you, Janine. Thank you.
So the place I like to start with when I'm talking with people is about childhood and what was your childhood like, and can you see any links to the first stepping stone in relation to animal communication in your childhood?
Yes, so you had to talk with my mom. She will say that I was a kind of a strange child. So basically, since I was a child, I was very connected with animals. What I had in my mind is when my grandfather used to bring me to the mountains, and there are still like two old uncles for me. Nello and Concetta, the name. And the first time, every time that I was there, I was going to the stable to scratch the bulls and the cow, to stay with the chickens. Mm. And I remember once my grandmother, as I was very fascinated and attracted by animals, brings me to the zoo in Tuscany. And while she was handling me and with the pullover here and looking to the elephant came toward to us and ate the pullover of my grandmother. So she was really, really afraid that the elephant was going to die and then she had to buy a new elephant because she ate all the pullover. So just to give you some idea, it was always with animals when I had the possibility, because I grew up in the city and I just had some like goldfish and the classic animals, no cats, no dogs, mm-hmm. since I was growing up. But this was, I think, the all experience I had in contact with animals. Mm-hmm. I didn't grow up like in a family that was open to spiritual, that was knowing that it was possible to communicate with animals. I didn't know since I had the first experience. So I can say that I had like a normal childhood, but I had this attraction with animals. Mm-hmm. But I see now because most of my friends now as they have child, all the child has this attraction because we come from that world. And I think that this is quite common childhood that I had. And mm-hmm. but when I speak with the family of my friends and also my brother, that's what was my brother. I was in Sweden last week, mm-hmm. and my niece. So it was Elias. They had to do something. They say, okay, if you do it, we can give you a present, so you can choose whatever you want. And then you think a little bit, say, a dog. So this was the most beautiful thing he can express. And and when we grow up, we are still there. So we grow up and we see that we have this attraction with animals and we need them.
Yeah. So I was actually going to ask you what you think the attraction is, but that's probably going to come in later because we're going to talk deeper about that. about what animals mean to us. So do you remember any specific experiences with any animals when you were a kid? Like, do you remember that experience with the elephant and what you thought about it? Did you have any thoughts about, you know, what had happened? And
actually the elephant was very, very little, so my grandmother used to like tell me the story, yeah, every time. But what comes into my mind actually is a picture, because I don't have the memory, but I have the picture in mind, because I saw the picture, mm-hmm, me with the chimpanzee, mm-hmm, and one next to each other. So like it was a friend of mine. Mm-hmm. And it came to my mind now because then I had the opportunity to stay with the Jane Goodall Institute in South Africa and communicate and work with the chimpanzee. And this was a beautiful spin, because you can see the link between what was like a dream and it was just a picture, and then became part of my journey. Mm. And also the experience that I have with the bull, because my when my uncle was coming to me, you know, to the stable, say, "Oh, please, Andrea, be careful, because he's a bull, he's not like a dog." Mm. But I was not seeing the bull like a bull. For me, was an animal, and it was beautiful, and it was what is nothing is not related to what animals gave to me, but what my uncle gave to me, because how he was looking to me while I was stretching the neck of the bull, and the bull was relaxing and he was very calm, and then he started to laugh and say, "He's a bull." So there you can see when the adult mind that consider a bull like a bull for reproduction, in this case, he has a very small stable in the mountain, and then he completely see the bull in another way, like a cat or a dog, as it was for me. So this was a beautiful experience that I bring, brings me a lot, because if you approach an animal that is, that could be apparently like aggressive or, aggressive, but then you approach with a different way, is not aggressive. I was in Florence, like 1 month ago, more or less, for a conference, and there was this dog in the house. Mm-hmm. It was a big villa, and that is like a B&B, and the dog is always close because it bite people. Mm. And then when I was there, I just say, "Just leave it open, let's see." Say, no, Andrea, please, no, Andrea. And we were there with another male dog, so it was impossible. And what happened, he start to play with the other dog. And then they say, no, now we have to close it, because we are going to the chicken's place. And we are afraid that the dog will follow the chicken and eat the chicken. They say, "Have you ever tried?" No, but he's like that. Mm. They say, "Okay, you are here, try." We try, and we went through the, and he did nothing. And in that weekend that we were there, the dog was what they expect the dog to be in all their life. Yeah. And he didn't bite no one. He was very calm, relaxed to the other dog, nothing to the chickens. And they were surprised. And is the energy that you bring to the field. So your energy will cope with other energy. And if you are in the approach that your energy is calm and positive, all the animal energy resonate and vibrate in this direction. Mm. This is why the magic happened, and the dog was very calm. And then they start to realize that they can even give the dog the possibility to run in his beautiful garden, because it's not more anymore a problem for them. And if you change your behavior, your thoughts, then it changes the reality around you.
Yeah, exactly. And their fear of what might happen can be, you know, can stress out the dog or the other animals so much that they end up by responding in the way that people think they're going to respond. But then, as you say, when there's calmness and when the animals are given trust as well, then they respond so differently.
Yeah, just to give an example, when I was going out with my dog, that now she is in spirit, I had, there was a dog in particular, another female, and when we see each other with the lady and the dog, she always take her dog next to her and say, no, now there is the Lulu. So please take Lulu away, my dog, because, and it will start barking. Okay, the same dog with the husband. So he was a friend of mine, and with the husband, we start to talk every time. And the day after we met his wife, and there was this like a fight. It was him with the bicycle. We were on the channel, so there was like 1 meter space, so there was no space to run. So it was him with the bicycle, with the dog, me with the dog, with anything, and the dog were there very calm. And every time was like that, with the wife. Yeah, always yeah. Fight with yeah. Husband, nothing. Okay. So this is she was responding to the fear of the her to the wife that was with her, and when there was the husband, it was very calm. So for her, there was not a danger around. So it was her behavior was very very calm. So you can see how we can. The word is comes like perform. So let's assume that we are actors, because we are actors and we perform a story every day. So it depends to us which mask, which dress, which color we want to perform, and the audience will react to how we perform and how we show up. So. And this, you can see the colors and the mask or the dress. And like a metaphor, you could say in English, metaphor of your thoughts and your behavior, your energy. So it's not a real dress, but it's how you behave. And everything around will cope with this. So sometimes we face difficult situation, like with animals or also with people. And then we start, okay, we have a problem. But I have a problem. Sometimes I create that problem. So I call Andrea or I call Janine because my cat has a problem. But then maybe the problem is me, it's not the cat. The cat is showing me something. So when you open to see that there are different levels of reality, because there is not like this screen, but there is something else. Then I think the magic happens, because you start to see and you start to feel that there is something different, and your perceptions, your intuition will go in a direction where everything comes. I want to give an example, because for me was is beautiful. So just to see how things happen and the power of the mind in relation with animals. So this is a very personal story. When there was the lockdown here in Italy, I was in my town with my family. And I thought, oh, this is a terrible period. Let's find something good, something that gives me love. What makes me happy? And the first thing was chicken. A chicken. But I didn't have the chicken, and my family wouldn't allow to have a chicken in the house in the city. But every time I was considering and seeing the chicken, so let's see, mom, there is a chicken in the under the table every day. Oh, there is a chicken there. With my imagination, I was creating that chicken. Till a point when, before going in the house, I start to smell the smell of the chicken, because when I was a kid, I had I one. So I remember the smell that you have when you have like in a cardboard in a house. So this dream, and then a dream is not a dream, but is a reality in another dimension, was I was bringing down on the third dimension. So from imagination was a sense of smelling. It happened that after a month, after they opened like our doors and we were able to go out, I was already here in this house on the hills, and I tried to find a house to have chickens. So I didn't stop to dream when like the big trauma of the lockdown was finished, but I was following the dream, and now I'm here with the chickens. But what happened? The idea was to have a chicken that makes the blue egg. This was a dream that I had since 15 years ago. The blue, I want a blue egg. The dream was a blue egg. So I had all these chickens, but not the one with the blue egg. So I went on the north of Italy to bring home this special chicken. And I didn't wait the right time. So it was my ego that was saying, oh, you have to have it, you have to have it. So I bring it here. And what happened? They had a big flu. So here in this room, I had for 3 weeks, five chickens, because it was winter, not winter, but was very, very cold. So they had to stay in a warm place. So the only place warm was inside the house. So imagine like a normal house with five chickens. It was a mess all around. And this blue one, guess which was the last one to make the egg?
The blue one.
The blue one. So yeah. I had the dream, but it doesn't come in the way we think.
No, exactly.
You have to wait, you have to grow, there are steps. And she was the last one. And while I was here, I had a chicken that was very, very ill, and she was staying in the shower, because we had only four cage at the time, and was very, very ill, making a lot of noise, was going died, actually. The vet said I never listened a chicken with so pain. And say, okay, we have a 24-hour like clinic, you can come. And my girlfriend tell me, because we are all human, no? So when you are in this pain and this emotional field, you don't use your heart a lot, no? So you are in the panic.
Yeah. And
my girlfriend told me, Andrea, why don't you ask? And I say, okay, yes, I can ask. So I was there in the bathroom, and I asked, what I have to do? So what I have to do here? And it came to me three things. Call his father and tell him to come here, not let her go to the town. Pray, a certain amount of pray. Don't go to the vet. So just imagine to have a chicken that is dying with all the blood. It was terrible. I say, okay, to my girlfriend, do you trust me? I say, yes. Call your father and come here. It was a red zone, so he was not able to come here. And she said, no, I'm going home. I said, no. The message was, your father, trust me, call your father. So she called her father. He came here. And what happened when he went, because he has a cage at home for this chicken, but when he went out, he found another cage on the street. So actually we were able to sit all the chicken in a more comfortable way. So he came and he found the solution that we needed. I didn't went to the vet because I trust the intuition, even if the reality was either go to bed, the vet, or she was going to die. The following day, she was fine. Until I finished the last praying, it took me 3 days. When I finished the praying, all the chickens start to eat. And and they recovered. So, and they are still mm-hmm. here and they're fine. So just to say to the people that are listening that it's important to believe in your dreams. So yeah. even if it's not real, just believe. And then, because if it's your dream somewhere, we don't know where, but somewhere is a reality. Mm. You just have to believe enough to give energy to let this dream grow. Mm. And when you feel a dream and you realize a dream, it's not only, for example, the chicken, but is which is the meaning to have a chicken in my life. Mm. And the meaning is that I was able to go out of my family, so the freedom. Mm. And the chicken has the wind, wing,
yeah.
Yes, to fly. So this is the message is now you can fly, but the chicken doesn't fly a lot, if you know, no? They just do
it. No, they just bounce, yeah.
Yeah. Kind of, yeah. So what does it mean that mm. in my this in my life, I fight against the reality to gain and to achieve freedom. Mm. Now it's my turn to fly because yeah. I have the wings, but I had to do a step further. Mm. This is why I have chicken and I don't have like for example, a hawk or another mm. bird that flies. Mm. So there is this compenetration between reality and the meaning behind this reality. Mm. Intuition is, for me, is a fundamental because if you don't use your intuition, you don't have this compass, no? How mm. to manage in this world, how to find your way. And your way is not outside you, is inside you. Mm. So in a way or another, we need to come inside, mm. Come back inside in our space, in the space. And from there, we can take out anything, mm. Anything, because we have to remember, especially now that we are a spirits, or we have a body, but we have also spirits, and there is no limit, no limitation for our spirits. Mm. And we don't, I think that there are no teachers in this world. When I start my webinar or my workshop, I say, I'm not a teacher. Maybe the animal could be a teacher to show you how to communicate. I just share my experience, but the teacher is you. Mm-hmm. So each of you are the teacher of yourself. I think that there is no one in the world, or just few people, but few, I mean few, like counting in a hand.
Yeah, one hand, yeah.
That can say this is in Italy we say maestro, like a real spiritual guide. So, but mm. a lot of the other people can show you their experience, but this is important for us to take the experience and make believe in our potential. Mm. So there are people that can guide through their experience to find what we have inside. And this, I think, is the best teaching that we can have and we can share with people. So not saying I'm your teacher, but I guide you to find yourself. And this, I think, is the most beautiful way how to say I love you mm. in another mm. way.
Yes. So did you, I mean, this is kind of where you are now in your, you know, understanding of life and being human and that sort of thing. So, but you didn't start out like that. Where did you come from to get to the workshop with Winter in 2010? What changed in your life if you didn't grow up around spirituality? So what made you aware that there was something possible as animal communication?
It was a documentary. Mm-hmm. So I was in England doing my thesis in engineering. Mm-hmm. And I was watching a documentary about Africa, so a classic documentary about wildlife. And it was really fascinating. And my mate, was a French guy, he told me, if you like it, why don't you go there? And when he say, why don't you go there? It came into my mind a picture of a white lion. So it was not about that documentary, because it was not about white lion. It was classic documentary.
Did you know about white lions?
No.
So you'd never heard, and it just came into your mind. Yeah.
Yes. I think I saw like a movie or a video. I don't know but it was before that experience when I was in Italy. So it could be 1 year before, I don't remember, but it was just like going on YouTube and see a picture of a white lion. I never heard about white lions in my life. Mm. So, and this is how I start to find out about white lions. I went to Africa, and when I had the opportunity to meet the white lions, I had the opportunity to make this I tried to call them and see what happened. This was suggest me to say, okay, Andrea, try to call and see what happened. So I was in the Jeep. There was Le Tabe Reduce.
There's Le Tabe there.
Okay.
That's Le Tabe. Yeah.
So it was him and his brother 30 meters away from me. Mm. And I close my eyes, I send a conditional love, and I said, please come towards me. And when I open my eyes, what happened for you?
Yeah, of course. Yeah, coming towards you.
No, they're sleeping. They're sleeping.
They didn't move.
They didn't move they stayed there.
Yeah, the ego.
Because
demanding the animals.
This was a lesson. So, for example, you can face a lot of challenging in your path when you open to spirituality or communication with animals. Is another world where we came from. We have all the knowledge, but as a child, when you go to the bicycle, so you need to make some practice, and you can fall down, but then. Mm. At the end, you can ride the bicycle. So that experience actually was very helpful for me, because I had only like an hour before going back to Italy. It was my last day, last morning. I will never have the challenge maybe to see the white lions again. So in that moment, the lion was still sleeping. What happened? I realized that when I was ascending unconditional love, was everything coming out from here. Was not feeling unconditional love. And after some years, I realized that it's not even easy to understand what unconditional love. Even if you have to feel it. Mm-hmm. Otherwise, are just words that we say, but we have to feel it. Yeah. So, at that time, what happened? I start to do the same exercise, concentrating to reduce the brother of Le Tabe, and send the same love, but without expectation. So I just send love to say, thank you for the experience. I stayed here for 4 weeks. It was beautiful. You are beautiful. That's it. And say, if you want to come, will be nice, but thank you. And with no expectation. And when I opened my eyes, he was next to me, like 3 meters from me.
Yeah.
And then I realized that in a way he was able to catch my thoughts. I didn't receive nothing, but I catch my thoughts. So this was the first experience. Then I came home. After 1 year, I went to the Malaysia. Mm-hmm. And then I had the second experience and it was beautiful, because we went to Sandakan. It was like a city in the Borneo, and there was a rescue center for orangutan. Mm-hmm. And then my brother, so we were very late, so it was full of tourists making picture, and we were far away, and my brother was too far to make a picture. So he told me, Andrea, if you succeed with the lion, why don't you call the orango? And I said, his name is Marco. I said, Marco, it happens last year, but I don't know how to do it. It was for chance that the lion came. Mm-hmm. But my brother told me, if you were able to do once, you can do it also twice. So I had done the same things. Unconditional love, please come to me if you want, of course. And the orangutan came next to us. With all the tourists that was behind us, because we were very far, so with the camera making pictures, and it was amazing. And then I was very, very curious after some time, and I said, let's see if it's real, this, because I had to experience, say, it's real, could be a dream to experience, really to communicate, because since that time I was able only to see that the animals was responding to me with their behavior, but I wasn't receiving any message. So I done the first workshop in 2010. And I remember that I was there. There was like a big window behind. It was a stable, in a stable we were, with all this lady. I was the only male. Very, very trained. So they had a lot of practice. So we started the communication with the cat, with the picture. And I opened my eyes. I was looking around with all people meditating. I never meditated in my life. So I opened my eyes and I thought, if someone will come here and watch to us, we'll think that we are crazy, because all around, with the eyes closed, with the picture in front of us. So it was not my place. I never been in this kind of things before. And then there was the question, which is your favorite food? And it came to my mind, carrots. So I didn't tell anyone that a cat liked carrots. And everyone say like fish or milk. And we were with Winter. Winter was confirming. So I stay in my place, not saying a word, because I was wrong. Second question, which is the big change in your life? So I close my eyes. I see like a table made by like steel, like the one of the vet, and everything white in my head. And then everyone said, "Oh, you have moved house." And Winter said, "Oh yes, I've moved recently house." And I receive white table. And in my mind, the connection was operation, because it was the table of the vet. So it was something related to the operation. But then, of course, I was there in the workshop, coming to Italy, saying none a word. So Winter said, please share what you received. So I was very, very skeptical. And I said, carrots, white, and operation, the table operation. And what came out was that the cat, of course, doesn't eat carrots, but used to eat the dog's food when there were carrots and the dog was not eating it. And what Winter didn't consider at the time was that the very, very friend of the cat, is another cat, Fred, she had the operation here. The ear were cut a few weeks before, and the cat is white.
Yeah.
But just to say that sometimes our mind, even if we have the right information, our minds will come up and say, you are wrong. You are wrong. And this, you don't have to expect if you have... if you feel comfortable to animal communication, you have starting like already a path, don't feel that this rational mind will disappear, because we are living in this world. It's like saying, I want my like glass floating on the moon, will float maybe, but here we have gravity. So we have the mind, we just have to use it in the proper way, not to imagine not to have the mind. So just recently, I had the case while a dog was very, very ill. And I was not like a center. I was not in balance. Mm-hmm. But when you need to help, you cannot help. That you cannot wait to be like in a meditation state. Everything is perfect. No, you have to do it, and you have to do it even if you are not okay. Mm. So let's do the communication. And the dog was very, very ill. And what I received was red and something like a cardboard.
Mm-hmm.
But was not helping the family. And but it was a distant communication, so I just need to deliver a message by phone, not even talking to the people. Mm-hmm. And then I was there, no, with this fear in me. And then what happened me to go further was, do I trust or I want to control everything? So say, okay, I need to trust, because it's not me doing the communication, it's something else, I'm just in the middle. So I took the phone, record the message, and then send.
Yeah.
And then I came here in the kitchen, and with my girlfriend, I said, I don't know how I was able to send it, because it was not me there. I'm not center. It was a crazy period. And and then what I received was a beautiful email that thanks me, because they find out that he was eating in the red box, something looking like a cardboard, is the one that you use to open the fire to...
like a lighter or a match?
It's not a match. It's something that is chemical. It looks like a cardboard, but you just light this piece. It's not a wood. It's a wood, but with some chemicals.
Yeah.
In Italy, we have it either white or like cardboard or wood.
Oh, it's like a thick piece of cardboard. That's what it looks like. Yeah, like a fire lighter or something.
Yeah,
like
and then you light it and it stayed the fire for a while.
Yeah.
And then I discovered that it was healed because he ate this one. So they find out what was the problem, what was coming from. And from the rational mind, you just have red and cardboard, what is it?
Yeah.
So you have, even if now is like 11 years, but it's still there, this mind.
Oh, yeah.
So are you sure? Are you sure? But at one point, you need to trust.
I can share my very first experience with animal communication was a workshop with Winter. I've shared this before, actually. We were at my friend's house and we were communicating with her dog, and Winter said something happened to Bob the day before. What was it? And before she'd even finished asking the question, I got yellow and black stripes in my mind. That was it. Just yellow and black stripes. But my mind thought, they've got horses. So, and then I saw a picture of a horse kicking him. So then we wait for my friend Claire to share what happened to Bob the day before. He'd got stung by a bee. And so that's my very first memory, because I remember very clearly, A, getting the black and yellow stripes, but also how my mind created the next image of him being kicked by a horse, which wasn't real. So, yeah.
Yeah, and it's very important, because when we have, when we do like a communication and of course we face a challenge, but I think this is normal for several reasons. A reason, for example, when I remember this lady in a communication, a workshop, she told me, your turtle likes to eat the carrots. Again, carrots.
Again, the carrots, yeah.
And of course it's not. But I didn't say you are wrong. What I asked her, did you receive carrots or the color? Just go back in your memory. And then she said, orange, it was orange. And then I say carrots. So sometimes the message is correct, but when you translate it into words, It's not something that you do intentionally, but you can create an interpretation of the message. So she said, okay, it was orange. And then I said, okay, melon. She likes melon, and this is her favorite fruit. So you are right. But if you say carrots, you are wrong. And it's very important when you find the challenge, because also for me, it works the same. I done a communication with the dog. I received everything while it was eating, going out. And I wasn't able, this was my judgment, to find out that it was dead. So in the message that I sent to the family, for me, and I also said in the message, because I, then I went and let's listen what I told them, the dog was alive. So this was for me a very, very challenging communication, because doing like with a lot of expectation from the people and saying that it was alive, but it was already dead, this dog, I was judging myself, say, how is possible, Andrea, that you were not able to detect that it was dead? But this was a beautiful lesson for me. And the thanks that I make this communication, the thanks the family that send complain to me, because you have to see behind. So like the chickens, so they are ill, but why they are ill? So what your what makes that experience in your spiritual path? So a lot of this experience, I think most of them, all this experience, let's say all, are there because you can do a step further. What I understood from that experience, that I went more deep in the spirit. And when you leave your body for a certain period of time, you are not going on another planet. You stay there. You are around. It's like when you... before a child will burn, the spirit will go to you, to your husband, to your sister, will visit all the people that will we will have a relation. So in a way, they know already us before coming in the body. And when the animal, in another way, is going in this, coming back to spirit, it will stay a little bit around, especially if we have a lot of pain. So we are stuck in them here. This is why not to have fear to, or not fear, like to cry. It's like okay, you can have your emotion, but not let this emotion overcome you. No, you have to be open to understand that death is a part of life. And as a rabbit told me, life is part of life. Life is part of life that is bigger. So I understood that the I was not making a mistake. I was feeling his energy that was already there. And from the perspective of the dog, he was still there. He was eating, he was going out in the same way, he was sleeping in the same room. He was there.
But just not in the physical form that he had been in before. Yeah. So, I mean, I can hear you said when you went to that first workshop with Winter and there was lots of people sitting around, women apart from you sitting around meditating with their eyes closed, and now you're talking about you know communicating with the spirit of a dog, and I know that you're doing other stuff as well, which hopefully you'll share. How did you get from there to here? What's the path that you took? Because it sounds like to me there's been a lot of learning and realizations in your journey.
This makes me cry a little bit because yes, because we don't have to be so like strong as the people want us to. It's beautiful to be how you are. Now I'm, if I don't control, I start to cry. because it happened that in my life came a person, like a physical person, that we know each other since I don't know many life. And then she was following me since the beginning, since the first experience of the Lions. She never showed up. Just to say that there are people that are next to us, okay, and also spirits next to us, even yeah, if we don't realize that they are there. So we are not alone. And one of the last messages I received was that you don't have to control life. You just have to live life, trust the life. And this person, it was amazing because when they talked to her about me, he said, ah, yes, this guy that the elephant told him this and this and this and this and this. And I had this experience, not the giraffe, sorry, giraffe. This is a Doolittle when I was in Israel. And this was exactly the same word that the giraffe told me. Mm-hmm. And she referred this to a person that I knew. So, and the beautiful experience that she shared to me and the teaching was to try every day to cut my ego. Mm-hmm. So what I create was a beautiful castle, but was a crystal castle, mm-hmm, where I was the animal communicator in Italy, recognized also abroad. I had a lot of people coming, you know, a lot of women. So I'm a man and I was falling in love with a lot of girls. But this was how you create your crystal box, where you are the teacher, where you you perform a communication, where you use your power not in the right way, because you use your power for fascinating people. And mm, a lot of people create this link with not giving the wind not to fly, but bringing people, okay, stay here because I bring you where, but you need to stay here because I have the knowledge. Mm. So the beautiful teaching was take out everything. So go down to the ground. You are the last one, mm-hmm, if you want to grow up. So I start to saying that all my fear in the publicly in the workshop. So I have the fear that you ask me what the animals say, and maybe I'm here handling your energy and not able to even communicate with the dog, but I'm here teaching you. Mm-hmm. And I start to say, I'm not teaching, I'm just sharing my experience. So going down, respecting women more, so it was a big, big work that I'm working every day. Mm. And there I start to realize if I don't put me there in this crystal box, like as an animal communicator, I'm not anymore an animal communicator. So what I am, I don't know, but I can communicate with a tree, I communicate with the water, I communicate with the wind, I communicate with other dimension, other what you believe. You can communicate with your gods. You don't have to go to the priest or to the church to communicate with your god. You can do it every day, and they respond. And when they respond is change your chemicals, change actually your chemical in the body, so you understand when there is a high communication, because there is something that is you cannot sleep, you do everything impossible and you perform it. So since that moment I do a lot of step behind, but this was make me then more steps forward. And I think she really helps me. So I think that sometimes in our life, if we are open and humble, you say like that in English,
humble
mm-hmm, humble enough to say, okay, mm, I can learn a lot. She's saying something really bad to me, but maybe it's right to listen and to take this teaching, because sometimes we respond, no, I'm not like that. But most of the time we are like that, but we don't want to see it.
No.
And this is how I start to become a new journey. That is, I think, our journey. So we are in the same journey all together. So actually, this is what happened in the last years. And I'm really glad that I tried to say I am. So I am, I think, is a big mantra, because when you say I am, there is a big power in this two words, I am. Because you can say, I am Janine, I am a mother, I am an animal communicator, I am a bank officer, I am a football player, but you can be everything, but there is always I am. Mm. So all the rest is mask, or but there is always I am. So when you go inside to find out who you are, and this is a path that maybe takes a life.
Yeah. Just the who discover. I am. Who am I question is eternal, isn't it? Yeah.
And it takes a life to understand a little bit. Then when you are in spirit, you remember everything. And then you come back and you start again, not the journey. But then it's beautiful. It's beautiful because can happen everything, and especially now what we are facing, like in Italy, is a terrible situation. But they can come to me and say everything, you have to do this, if you don't do this I will do this to you, but I will wait this moment till to see where I am, how stable I am. And if it comes, I will say to these people, I am. And they will not understand, but this is beautiful. I am. So you can even kill me, but life is part of life. You don't kill my spirit. So it's, then you find a lot of power inside you. You can find helps, because when you are humble enough to understand that you are part of the whole and you are not more important than the an homeless or your dog or the tree, then more humble you are, more open you are, and more help you receive. And we cannot fail in this life.
Actually, it can take a lot to get to the point where you can do that authentically. I mean, I'm constantly, you know, pulling myself back into line, because you know, as you said before, like as a human, we get pulled away by life, by society, and we have to remember again and again to come back, you know, to pull ourselves back into alignment.
But it takes a while if you believe that it takes a while.
Okay.
Could happen that it takes a second. It's really click. Now what we are facing is a period, especially 2021, because it representing the number 3. So now we are in a period where we have to create. And create, for me, it means to take out what makes our heart beat. So you have a dream, do it, to paint, start to paint. No one cares, don't care, paint. If the day after you want to cook, let your spirit behave in this reality. And you will become more familiar to this world that is part of you. So it could take, it is written like in the books, that you cannot find here, but in the books where everything is written, that humans need 1 year of hard work to show the, I would say in English, the light of the sun. It is a condition of the human. When you incarnate in this body the Son of the Light. You just need, you just take 1 year of hard work.
Mm.
But what I see is that not all the time we have the, how to say in English, we have the, we are patient enough to work. We expect, because this is the society, everything to work straight away.
Like we're impatient and we want to like take a pill and have everything okay.
Yes, like when you are ill, you take a pill because your create a separation between your soul and your body, and then you don't feel the pain. And then, but why you have this pain? So even if you take the pill, then you come back and you don't have the pain, but the problem maybe is not in the head, it's going to the legs. And then after a while you have a problem with your legs, and then you take the pill, boom, no pain, come back. But I try every time to say why I have this problem, what is teaching me. Some times ago, like 2 months ago, I wasn't able to walk. So why I cannot walk? And everyone say, okay, take this medicine. I didn't took nothing. I just stay with my pain, say what I have to understand, which is the meaning of this. So if you stay, every experience that you have, just imagine that you have a gym, and the gym is your daily life, and every day you have the solution to go further and to overcome every problems. So don't give an expectation, don't make a timing. No, it will hard. I would love to communicate with animals, but I don't meditate. And then what happened? I never meditate. So
so you never communicate.
So just do it, and don't say that it's difficult. You cannot do it today, do it tomorrow. You succeed just once in 10 times. Okay, but maybe it's your path that you have to overcome a lot of fear before you receive more fluently. Because if you are alive, the connection with the divine is there. So I think that is impossible that someone doesn't receive message, because we are connected. So because we are alive, so you can receive, everyone can receive. The point is how many preconditioning are in your mind, how you have been told since you were a child. Of course, my childhood was very, very simple in a way, classic. If I was grew up maybe in a family where they were more open, maybe it took me not 11 years but less years not to discover it. The new generation are very, very advanced compared to us. If you take a child, I've done a workshop with children. You don't have to take a 2-day workshop. You just express in 10 minutes. Okay, the principle is you send love to the cat, ask, and then you receive and you tell me. And I remember,
and that's it. They can do
That's it. And we were in Rome, and there was this baby. She was coming from Dubai, even if she was Italian, so was speaking Italian and English. And we said, where does the dogs likes to go? And this little, how you say, not daughter, like children.
Child? No.
Child. It was a female. I don't know how you say in English.
Yeah,
child.
A girl.
A girl.
Little girl.
Little girl, yeah. And she was saying, surfing. And we didn't understand surfing. And then, because he wasn't able to speak, like probably was 4 years old, no? He would say surfing. And when we asked the lady, so where do you go with your dog? She said, I'm a surfer. I was surfing and the dog comes to me. Of course, she stay on the beach. But this is what I had in my mind. And this little girl, 4 years old, surfing.
Yeah, because they haven't learned to shut it off. They're much more open, and
So yeah. If there are any mother listening this conversation, please let your child do whatever they want. Just take my experience. I've done all the school, I become an engineer, and then I'm here talking about animals. So you will find your way, even if you start the classic life. So life will correct and you are all experienced, but the new generation are completely different compared to us, are more advanced. They are not here from the experience that I have to stay on a desk in the school. If they want, let's go to the school, but just let them express what they want to do, because they have the talent that are amazing. And maybe you are worried to create a future for them. And maybe you don't know that you have a master in your house and he will guide you through life. So, I mean, it's a beautiful experience because you learn every day. Every day as a teaching. So, coming back to how much time do I need to find who I am, apply this to the animal communication. So if you have any doubt, you see other people that are very, very, very good in communicating with animals, stay on your journey. Don't desire life on another one. Don't desire that tomorrow you will communicate with animals. Just give yourself time and trust yourself. Because everything will come. And this is something that gives you a lot of power. I think when we all die, let's imagine that you have a book. It's the book of your life. And then there is not God judging you. It's you reading this book and you judge yourself. So it's even more worst, because God is very open and full of love. You are very strict on yourself. So you will not judge from the result that you have achieved, but from the, impegno, from the efforts that you have put to achieve. So maybe your path is to communicate to animals. You dedicate your entire life to communicate, you never succeed. But your journey was to put effort and push your limit every time higher and higher. And when you are on the other side, you say, oh, I died and I never communicated with a dog. And then you see how much effort you have put through your life. And you are more advanced than someone that have done animal communication like for professionally, because that was your path.
Like the purpose,
And so no matter what we achieved, if we believe that something is good for us, just do it. Don't make an expectation on the path and on the results. So don't have any goals to achieve. Just put any effort, put your heart, and then you cannot fail.
And also, not like you say, not comparing yourself to other people is so important as well, isn't it? Because they're, as you said, everybody's path and journey is completely different.
Yeah, because I feel on my I see it, because when I speak about lions and I speak about my experience, I had people booking and going to the lions. That is nice because it's a beautiful experience, but understand that this was my journey. So why you have to go to Africa while you can achieve the same results, maybe going in your garden? Maybe
They're copying what you're doing rather than following their own hearts.
Could happen. So this is important, because just take from all the people that you will find in your life, absorb what they can give to you, but then you have to transform this information inside you. So mm-hmm. it's not like copy and paste. So no, he's exactly. successful because he's a very meditating people and making yoga every morning. Mm-hmm. I don't meditate and never making yoga. Mm-hmm. To communicate with animal, I need to be vegan, no? Mm-hmm. It's not like that. Just follow your path. And what I discovered, this is was beautiful, was the 2nd of May 2019. I was on a forest and I went for a walk. Mm-hmm. Then I stopped because I said, I always tell the people to ask the permission before going in the forest, and I didn't done it. So mm. I went out of the forest, asked the permission, because sometimes you are very, very good to speak, but you have to...
yeah, it's easy to say something, not necessarily to do it yourself.
Yes, yeah. And so this is very, very important. So I've done it, then I went back to the forest and I found this huge rock mm-hmm. where you can also sleep inside, because it's like this huge rock, and there is like an hamaca of rock where you can lay down here. Mm-hmm. So I lay down here and the rock start to speak. Mm. And told me, I am a rock. And I thought, okay, I can see like a big stone. You are a stone. Okay, I can tell you are a stone. But then he starts speaking and said, you can fly. You can fly wherever you want. Birds can fly. But I am a rock. I am a stone. And what was the teaching here? You can fly, you can do experience, you can go in South Africa, South America, you can go in Alaska, but you don't know who you are. Mm. I am a stone, so I know who I am. This was the meaning. Mm. And then she told me, look at me. And then there was like a mask, like the vegetation on it. There was hands, there was a tree going up. And the message was, when you find yourself, you don't have to go. The world comes to you. So I cannot move because I'm a stone, but I have animals here. I have a tree on top of me. I'm covered of this beautiful grass that grows in the forest. Mm. And this was a beautiful teaching for me. Mm. And everything I think is there. Because also animals, what gives to me, when I speak to people and say, oh, Andre, I signed for a workshop to communicate to animals, my reply is, to come to a workshop to communicate to animals is like buying a car because it has air conditioning. You don't buy a car because you need air conditioning, because you have in the house. You buy a car because you have wheels.
Yes, wheels.
Wheels, and to drive, and to, no, you buy the car for that reason. So when you approach it, for my experience, approaching animal communication to communicate with animals is like buying a car because there is air conditioning. So, because there is much more behind, because when you listen an animals, you start to listen yourself. When you listen yourself, you start to open up your heart. And then you start to discover who you are, little bit, step by step. You start to trust your intuition. So it's not like just talking to an animal, but the same technique applying to yourself. What happened when you go to work, you know? And then you realize what's going on. Because if you ask yourself, you know what's going on. And then you face situation in another approach, because you see the matrix that is behind, like a normal meeting. Or you start to feel different. The people is not your enemy. It's like a master that shows me my ego. Because if it's an enemy and it came friction inside me, it means that this friction is mine friction. It's not his friction. The problem is mine. Otherwise, I wouldn't react. I would be in balance. So if someone say, Andrea, after 2 days, I wasn't able to communicate to animals. For me, as a person that is guiding people, it doesn't, I don't care. It doesn't matter if you succeed or don't succeed, because just to sit there, to take the chance to discover something that is out of the conventional world, is mean that this door, you have, at least you have to, you have unlocked the door. Now it just give time to open this room. And when you discover the room, you will discover that there is a palace to discover, not just that room.
Yeah.
And this is, to summarize my path up to now is, thanks to open this door, I discovered that there is another door behind. And if I'm lucky enough and humble, I will discover another room tomorrow.
I always say to Winter's students that when you're learning animal communication, it's about so much more than animal communication, because it's exactly as you said, it opens up this whole world. And so much of it is about finding out about ourselves and healing and following our true path, which, as you say, is completely different. We don't copy and paste. We follow the path. But for a lot of us, we have to get rid of a whole lot of, you know, programming to remember what it is that we actually love doing. And then once we start doing that and open our hearts, then we get more inspiration. And yeah, so
and
you say,
like, if people are facing challenges, just my experience teach me that when I bring this experience to Italy, there was still animal communicators in Italy, but few, very, very, very few, and they didn't expose a lot. And for me, it was so amazing that I start to expose, like radio, TV. They speak to me in a bad way, the TV, actually. It was a terrible period, but it was beautiful teaching that involves a river. This is a story. I don't know if you have the time to speak about this story.
Yeah, but,
Just to say that I had this beautiful crystal. Just imagine, it was my dream to communicate with animals. And I shared with everyone. And I didn't found none that will saying, you are right. All the people say you are wrong. It's not possible. The friends, the family. So this to say that now, and I see going back 10 years, the time is going very, very quick. So animals before was used like dogs to protect the house. Now dogs are used, most of, like the majority of the dogs are here because we need the dogs, not to protect our house. So the relation with animals has changed. The energy of the planet has changed. So what was unacceptable 10 years ago now is it start to be accepted, and people start to speak about energy. Before was not like that. There are more people, and this give breath, no? You can and people can express themselves, say, oh, but I don't communicate with animals, but I can heal people. I can communicate with the trees. And all the people start to show up in this period where the coronavirus put a lot of fear, a lot of darkness, that I don't think is like that, because it's a beautiful light period. Because, but let's say that is darkness. All the lights, like Janine, all you are communicating in England, you in Finland, you can see the lights now. So there's a lot of cloud to oppress our heart. But then with all this darkness, you can see all the white dots.
So
we are showing up. Now you cannot hide anymore because you have to take decisions. And here is the point where we really had the opportunity to do these steps. And from the message I received, we have also the opportunity to see our ego, the personality in another way, and our soul on daily life. So you don't have to meditate, but when you act like you are doing like your shopping or whatever you're doing, you can apply this distance observation to yourself, because nowadays your soul is able to see your personality, and you can see who I am now. I'm more soul or I'm more personality. And you can see this and choose where you want to be, no? And this distance that is creating some pain in some people, also physically, because when there are a lot of ego in some part of the body, then you could have pain. So in this period, you are facing challenging things, could be seen like in a positive way, because you are doing this, you are becoming more aware of your spiritual life, not only the material life.
So do you, when people are, you know, experiencing that pain, I mean, as I have as well, and you said about, you know, you were having pain in your legs. I'll admit, I don't sort of see, look at, you know, the, feel the pain in my back and think, I know what that's from. You know, I take some painkillers and think, okay, let's just get on with the day and forget.
No, I don't want to say that you don't have to. This is my, I'm strange. But this is very important, because for 10 years I was seen as a strange person, because I was saying I communicate, I listen to animals. But now that people that have a heart has seen like different, because you have to follow protocols, but people that start this journey couldn't fit in a protocol because they start to question what's happening in the world. So this is a very, very strong power, because we are different. So it's not the people that want to feel us different, because we are, I am different, because we all are different in a way, but we have different sensibility. Even if you listen this message and you're not familiar with animal communication, but you stayed here for a 1 hour, it means that your soul is absorbing something from what we are sharing, and this has to grow and is growing inside you. So it doesn't mean that you don't have to take pills, but so you have to take care about your body. But while you are doing this, just think, while, and also for me was the same, the back. And the back is related to release of fears. So from my experience, when you have a physical problem, it comes to your, because it was there also before, the problem. There is one day that you feel it on your body, but it was there. No, you don't have a cancer one day to the other. It's growing, and then it was a point when it show up. So when it show up illness, it means that you have the ability to overcome the problem. So if I have a problem in my shoulder, let's see what doesn't mean shoulder, which is the meaning of a shoulder. If I have a problem with my hand or with my eyes, so what I don't see. If I have a problem in my ear, what I don't listen. So, okay, you can take a pill, but pay attention to what people tell you, and are you listening or not? So there is this second level of experience your daily life.
So do you have a reference to you know, the back being fear, and you know, if you've got a problem with your eyes, but that's kind of obvious, but you know, if you have a pain in your wrist or some kind of something, you know, wrong with your skin, or I don't know, something like that, do you have a reference that you look at, that you look up and see what physical problems relate to what, or do you just sort of go within and ask, and then you receive the information?
So a part of this like person that is next to me, that thanks God that she's there, but I don't have any book actually. This was a fear that I had, or a complaint, because I never study. Also in this path, I never open a book. I start to open like a book for Penelope Smith, but I never finished this book. I never open a book of anything. I never study anything. but I experience from life. So information will come. If you start to find the solution, what does it mean the shoulder? It will come either in a newspaper or on internet or a person that you speaks. So it will come.
You just be aware of things that come into your awareness.
Even if you don't have the knowledge, just be aware that there is a meaning. So just be aware that there is a meaning while I have this problem. It means that you are in a way handle it. So like my back, I stay in bed for 3 weeks. Mm-hmm. Now my back is going back to have some problem. Mm-hmm. And all the people, okay, make like a resonance to check. Mm-hmm. What I did, I start to go running. Mm-hmm. So I said, okay, I have the problem, is there, but there is is not just physic. The physic is something that is related to my spiritual part. So I try to do my best every day to control my ego, to release my fears. Mm-hmm. And my body is there. So I like to do gym. I go to the gym to run. So I don't care the pain. The body will handle it. And I do my best to be aware of my fears. Mm. And I see not as a problem, but as an help. I don't know how to say.
Yeah, no, I think I understand. So it's like reminding you to keep your fears in check.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And
yes,
remember that when you are so out of you are more connected. When I was in the prison to do a workshop, there was a prisoner that he told me, Andrea, I have a fever, so I cannot attend the workshop. And I said, come. Because also from experience, when I was so out of energy or I cannot communicate, you just don't have any blockage, because you are, I can't do it, so you are completely open and you receive, and he received perfectly. So I remember once I had 39.4 of fever last year. And I was with my girlfriend in a hotel because we were skiing. Then I wasn't able to ski anymore, of course. I was in bed for 4 days. Mm. But when I was there, instead of take a pills, I told her, take the phone and record. And then I start to speak, because I start to see places around that, then people that live there confirm me. They explained me while I was there, the relationship that I have in the past life with the owner of the hotel. And then I remember this beautiful picture of stones with wrapped by paper. So we have inside us, this is just a picture, but very, very useful. You have all these stones with wrapped by paper, like an envelope. Put it there. And these are your past life blockage or your something that you have overcome. So sometimes you have to open the package, see this stone, say, okay, handle it. This is why you meet someone that challenges you, why you meet someone that you fall in love. So a lot of this experience comes from our past life. And then, and also animals. So why I have this dog, why I have a cat, or why my cat has this problem, why I stay at home with 15 wild dogs. This was a person that I knew. So your life is there. You cannot move because you have to take care about 15 like wolves. But this was related to her past life. So what she did to them in another life. So she was doing bad things to Wolf. Now her life is taking care of Wolf.
Yeah.
So there is a meaning also there. So our life is open this envelope, see the stone, facing the problem, overcome and put it back. And then you have another stone and then put it back. till you clean your, inside you everything. Mm. So then I think this for me gives a lot of power, because with all the difficult emotional things, with all the problems that we all have, because I'm not different to anyone, because don't see people from a screen different to you, because when I am at home, I remember my girlfriend, I said, I do a conference, you can stay at home because you listen to me every day. The answer was, Andrea, you are not like that in a daily life, I come. So this is a teaching, because I'm not the one that, because when you speak, you are more connected in a way, you are centered. Mm. But in the daily life, you face all the problem, all the ego that all the people have. So she told me, Andrea, in the daily life, you are like everyone. So when you are yourself, it's good for me to see you, because you're not like that now.
Yeah. So, when you're caught up with life. And I must say, you're still working as an engineer now. Yeah. So I, you know, how do you balance those two, you know, engineering, and especially I guess in the beginning when you came back and you were starting to develop your animal communication work, and at your 9 to 5 job as an engineer, how did you reconcile those two very different worlds?
So I remember when, because it was a period where before this like crazy period, we used to have like workshop together with Winter here in Italy, and also talking with Simon, and he was saying, what do you expect? So you have everything to do animal communication full time. What do you expect? So you have, so it's there, but it doesn't, even if people, and from eyes of people, it was ready to, I was not ready inside. So, and at the beginning I said, okay, this work is 11 years that I'm doing as an engineer in this company, before another company, for other years. So I said, I waste 11 years. This was my thought. Then I said, no, it's not wasting. I have to overcome some fear, and I tell you exactly what is happening. So at the beginning was, let's say, normal, because you start to take a little bit of the taste of the spiritual world with animals, and then you start to work. Then you taste more and more and more. Then you arrive to the point when you apply the animal communication and your work. So I stopped to my colleagues and say, Andrea, I cannot sleep. Then I receive message how to sleep, and I give advice. Or I was to my secretary once, and they said, sometimes you don't have to say everything, but I said, there is a guy next to you, he's very, very like shining, and is like he's a person that you know, and he's here, and he wants just to say hello. And he was completely crazy and said, what you are saying, Andrea? Say, I don't know, I see someone next to you, so this is why I tell you. But it was so, I feel so clear that I just whoop, told that. And what happened was that day was the celebration of the death of her cousin, and she was very linked to him. And her cousin was there. So then you, this, at the beginning is one step here, another step here. Then you two steps, but then it's all merged in a way in the same. And which is the biggest fear? How I can communicate to animals in daily life and have the money to live? Okay. So this fear, but this is, you want to do a cooker, you want to be a Reiki, or you want to heal, or you want to do crystal reading, but I cannot survive with crystal reading, so I have to go to the bank every day. But the solution is not in the bank, the solution is on the other way. So you have to go there, see if it's real or not, this fear, because if you're not there completely, you don't know how much money you can have, no? So working as an engineer makes me to be more comfortable on the spiritual path and not having the problem of the money. So I have a salary, but I can do the animal communication and all the other stuff. So I started, this was one of my biggest fear, and I start to handle it. So growing here, not having the problem of arriving at the end of the month to pay the bill for the house. So this is not, it's very important, I think, no? So have the possibility to grow up and have the stability. But then you arrive at a point where the money that you receive is not enough to compensate what you receive where you are one. So when you communicate, when you do a talking like you now, when you do a workshop, there is something that you can be tired, then you are not tired anymore. You can have a wrong day, and then you, when you speak, you, comes the solution and you... So then it's not anymore the money, it's what makes you... Alive. And it's not the money, the money needed for the body, but what makes you alive is communicating with animals, with your God, whatever the God it is, because the energy is one, at the end, all merging one. That is there. When I was here and collecting mushroom last night, yesterday, and eating mushroom, this is like a poetry for me. Is like, it's a miracle to just walk, find mushroom in my garden and eat what I collect. There is no price that can give me this emotion, like going to free Michelin star here in Modena restaurant. Doesn't give me the same connection with the nature that I have finding mushrooms, and thanks the trees that is dying but give me food. So I think that you need to give yourself the right time, because you have to face your fear. So put in like two columns. On the other side, I can receive this. On here, I have this fear. So, okay, start to work on your fear on daily life. Every day, the same topic, and start to overcome this fear. And then you arrive to the point where this fear is not the one that keeps you in your office. There is something else that makes you make the decision. It's not anymore that fear. So at the end, life is an experience. So you can, you don't have to change your life. You just have to live, and you can live doing your same routine in a different way, because it will be not become a routine anymore, because you can heal people in your office. You can have a training of facing your fear, just watching yourself when you are in a meeting with your boss and your body is attacking you, no? Where you are there, you are not stable. Okay, it means that you have to work a lot. And okay, but I know that I have to work. So the beginning was normal. Then I was feeling a lot of uncomfortable there because it was not my world. Then I understood that I was not ready enough to do these steps. And I start to say, okay, instead to be with my mind outside the office, just try to take the opportunity of the office to learn what I don't know that I have to learn, because I don't have the answer every time. But even if I don't have the answer, I know that I have to stay there, because if I'm there, it means that I have to stay there. And then I start to live my daily life at work with a different approach. And so it could be that you have to face fear, or could be that your colleagues needs help. So you need to be there to help people, because...
And just being open to what to whatever it is, and giving yourself the time that it takes.
And it was beautiful because now my gym is the office. I was with my colleague and I received a message while I was there and say, ask her to say what she see in you. Mm-hmm. I say, okay, let's do it. So the name is Valentina. I say, Valentina? I say, yes, Andrea, please. Say, tell me what you see in me. I say, what a question. I cannot read people. No, just tell me what you see me. And I was not watching anywhere else on your eyes, always, what you see me, what you see me. And I gave the power, but she found the power and she make a reading of myself that was beautiful. Mm. And she are out completely of this world. But she had the reading, for me was an incredible help. And now we talk, and I said, do you remember that day? I say, yes, I don't know how I did it, but she did it without any training. Just do it. And it was beautiful.
Mm. And if you hadn't have been there with her, then she wouldn't have had that experience.
No.
Yeah, you saw that opportunity for her. She didn't actually see it for herself. So, yeah, that's amazing.
Yeah, I mean, this is just my experience, and
So I think we probably need to wrap up soon. So I wanted to ask if you can share. We talked about there's the workshop. A lot of the work you do, obviously, you're in Italy, you're Italian, so a lot of your workshops and your work is in Italian. But you said that there's something coming up soon that is going to be in English, a workshop.
So I'm following life. So I knew that I already done workshops like in the United States, conference in Israel or in Canada, or I don't remember all the place, but I've done it. So what I see now that I'm here, so if my energy vibrate and resonate to someone and there is a community where my experience could help people, of course, I'm more than glad to share it and to guide people in terms of sharing the experience. So there will be, I think, soon, like also online workshops and so on. But I really follow, follow what comes.
Yeah.
I never ask to do a conference or make an interview. I'm just open. So if you need me, I'm here.
So you don't have a website, do you? So I'm going to share your email address.
Yeah, I have a small website that is also in English, but I have to do it very soon. But it's not in English. I mean, there is also the English, so you can share also, I can give you the link.
Yeah, okay.
But I really, the email you can write to us, who is next to me, Valentina, she's speaking fluently several languages, so.
And what was that, French, Spanish and English?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. So we cover most of the languages spoken and I think that it's a beautiful journey and I'm here for the French people because the book is all in Italian, but there is a book for French people. Mm. But I think that the book is an experience. My advice is don't read books, but just live life and take this. Live. Because the solution is in several books, but why people doesn't make the step further, because the solution is there for millions, is there. We are rewriting books, life after life, everything is there. I think now is the time to do things. So it's not anymore intellectual. Now we have to do it. So if you feel something, do it. Find where you can practice and then go on in your daily life. So
which, like we were saying, like this, my journey to this point doing these interviews and just doing it, not waiting to feel ready, just do it.
It's like going to the bungee jumping and feel ready not to have the fear.
It's
a part of the game, have the fear before jumping. So now is a period that or you are ready or you're forced. So just do it.
Better to do it by your own choice.
The worst can happen is dying. But you don't have to be afraid of dying, because dying is just the body and everything will go on. So nothing happened.
Okay, well, thank you so much. It's been really lovely talking with you and
fascinating. After a while.
And thank you for sharing your experiences as well. So
you're welcome, and thanks to everyone that will that are listening this message.
I'm sure a lot of people are going to learn a lot from you, and continue to watch your journey unfold and the offerings that you bring. So thank you so much, and thank you everyone for watching, and see you next time.